What's up, everybody? It's your boy Warren J back with another video, another gaming video for the channel. So today we're playing Alan Wake, and apparently this game came out a while ago. For some reason I thought it was new, but I guess it doesn't matter. I'm just trying some new games, some games that look promising. It looks pretty interesting, so I figured why not give it a shot. So we're gonna start a new game and making sure everything is okay. I know it's been a while, but it has been very, very difficult finding space and time to record these videos. Ooh, they got nightmare mode. Can't do it. Okay, normal. I think this is supposed to be like a...
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
That's a horrible dream, man.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Especially when you think it's real.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Episode 1, Nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Oh, we're starting in on the journey. Look up to the light. Wait. Reverse your controls for looking up and down. I guess not. Change your camera settings and an option. Oh, yeah, this is good. Okay. Let's get back in the car. Examine.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
Oh, he's got his book. You're not gonna pick that up?
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Wait, what button is the sprint button? Oh, there. Okay, my bad. Who's missing? You seen this man? That's not me, is it? Is that me? And by me, I mean him. Now he's...
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? Think you're God?
He's got an axe.
You think you can just make up stuff?
Hold on, fam. Hold on, fam.
I people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama.
Ooh.
one.
Never publish another one of your shitty stories.
Cause I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your story's already good. Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Oh, wow. So, okay, I must have missed something. Is he... What kind of writer is Alan? Because that sounds like he's like a journalist or something. Exposing people.
You missed your deadline!
You can dodge enemy attacks.
Damn.
Oh, okay. Ooh!
You can't stop me!
Try it again. Since without this, this highlight was set.
Okay. I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
So is this a fiction or non-fiction story? That would be trippy.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Fiction. Come on, bro. Getting tired. There you go. Come on, man. Freaky.
Die.
Kind of game did I choose? Okay, wait, what? He says in the lighthouse? Okay.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
Okay, how? Bam, come on, like, which way? Oh, I'm about to die. I can't get out!
Follow the light.
Man.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only okay. Safe there.
Okay.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Whatever he was saying sounded like part of the book.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Okay.
The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Wait, where? Oh, here?
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
This is trippy. I can't aim? There's no aim? Get away from me. Tap X to boost. Oops. Hold on.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Okay. Boosting the light, binds the enemy, burn darkness way faster. But it burns out my batteries. I didn't know the batteries were rechargeable, or, you know what I mean. Had I known that, I wouldn't have. Okay, whatever. Okay. And then what's with the, like, I can't aim my gun? Because this is flashlight. That's sprint. Yeah, can't aim. Okay.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
This man's gonna keep coming back. Back up, son. I need to. Hey. Back up, cuz. Let me be smart and pick up more ammo. Okay. Okay.
This is it, witch.
Whoa! Back up. Eek! Climb, man! Climb! Oh, this game is freaky. Oh! Pushing the wrong button. Are we good? Man, come on now. I got a flare gun. Switch weapons and throwables. Okay. And what do I use a flare gun for? Getting old, fellas. Oh! Okay. Now we know what the flare does. Yep. Have a good day. Okay.
Surprise!
Oh, come on, man. You can't be getting winded that easily. I got to do all this just to get to this lighthouse. I gotta quickly, please, quickly. He's getting closer. Finally. Why does this dude look like, what's his name? Okay, maybe not.
He's here. Alan, wake up. Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up,
now
handsome.
He looks totally different.
We're here.
A dream like that, I think I'd be afraid to go back to sleep. That is wild.
Vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan White.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you can relax and charge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you, too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Okay. This is the car, right? Because this is... car in the dream, right? But I mean, oh.
Come on, slow.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
So the car he dreamed about was actually on the ferry.
15 minutes?
Sure.
Or the car that he was in the dream was
Alan,
the same car.
Thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
I completely missed.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this.
Oh.
Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people
so that was
him
on that missing post.
I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you. Buy the
right.
Coffee.
So
just don't blame me when you fall in love.
Because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you on your own?
Do me a favor, Sonny! I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious?
Coconut again?
You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck.
I'm supposed to pick
now,
this up.
You need to give it a good solid whack.
Say what now? Oh my gosh. Oh, my bad.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
Why are you so loud? Sir? Sir?
Don't go in there, young man.
Oh.
You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky.
You don't want
to
die,
to get the key
you?
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Uber Eager fans listen. Always did.
There's a lot going on.
Don't ask me that she should change the bowl. This is what happens when you get sloppy.
No one tell me this man back here. Lifeless on the toilet.
Hello?
Oh, he out of there.
Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Time to go. Time to go back where we came from, because...
Cauldron Lake
chills
is a special me. Place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
There's a lot going on in this diner.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Struggling to keep up.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation. Where'd he come from? And I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman in here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. That sucks. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks.
Well, what key did that dude have? Because the car is driving.
It's pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
What's up with everybody being afraid of the dark?
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
What is this? Black Ops Zombies? Well, I guess you can't say that because, like, every horror game.
Anyone here?
You gotta find a way to turn
filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, there is a cellar.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Oh, okay.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Low. Okay.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here. Sleep here and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
What do you mean you thought?
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
So what do you guys think? Would you stay out here? Every time I see a game or a movie about it, cabin is not good. However, I don't think I would let that stop me from staying in the cabin at least once in my life. But something like this, I don't know. Because if something happens, that means you got to walk or run your way back to wherever your car is parked. That's the thing. That'd be a deal breaker for me. can't be surrounded. Well, I guess that wouldn't be a cabin if it wasn't surrounded by woods, would it?
Alice? Honey?
That rocking chair had to go. Because if I see that moving, I'm out. Let me see it moving one time by itself, and I'm out.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Uh-oh. It's about to get a little rated R up in here.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Dan, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, hey, hey! Just hear me
hey,
out!
Calm down!
There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan?
Hey, did y'all see that?
Alan?
Oh!
Don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God it, Alice!
Watch your profanity.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Bro, what it? Is he dreaming?
Damn it. Alice?
Oh, no.
Alice?
Oh, no.
Alice!
Why would you go outside like that anyways when the power went out like that?
I'm coming!
Okay, I need a minute. Okay, so when the light started flicking, why did it look like Alice, like the way she was crying for Alan was like he disappeared for a minute or something? And then of course, I'm sure y'all saw the woman standing in the background. Oh my gosh!
What the hell?
We gotta be dreaming. Please tell me we're dreaming.
Oh, no! Alice? Alice?
But why would he leave the house after the lights started flicking on and off? I mean, I understand you're upset about whatever, but...
Oh, no!
Oh, heck no. Come on. Man was blinded by
going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
This man was blinded by anger.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot,